Hey guys, welcome back to the room where I've been cooped up and spending like 90% of my awake time this last 3 weeks. I'm on week three of working from home. Today is my 4 month bump date. And
hey guys, editing Rebecca here. I just realized that this entire video, I completely forgot it was going out on Easter Sunday. So really quickly, I wanted to wish you and your families a happy, blessed, and safe Easter season starting today, and I hope that you all are enjoying yourself. If you don't watch this until later, I totally understand. Go celebrate with your family. Go video chat your mom. Love you guys.
I'm filming it in here because the nursery is not available. The baby is stuck at home here with me too. My mother-in-law is here watching her, and this is where I am. So let's get to the juicy good stuff and see how my pregnancy has been progressing. First thing, this week I am 17 weeks along, which means I am 4 months, like I said. It's nice doing these videos because otherwise I would not know how many months along I was. But this helps me keep track. So currently baby apparently is about the size of an onion, about 5 inches crown to rump. So that's 5 inches plus legs. And starting to feel a little bit bigger. I think I'm a little bit bigger than last month. You can check last month's video and compare if you want to see. Sorry if I'm not really wearing anything cute today because this is my quarantine attire. And it's also laundry day, and I wanted to wash the pants that I've been wearing almost every single day. So I'm wearing these leggings that I hate. But here I am. I wanted to get this filmed for you, so just let's all appreciate what we have. Where were we? Apparently baby is sort of working on swallowing. That's something important that she or he is working on right now. May or may not be starting to hear things. I'm getting conflicting information depending on what side I go to. So that's something that maybe is just in the offing. We'll see. But it never hurts to, you know, start talking to your bum. I have finally this month gained some weight. I am 2.5 pounds up from my pre-pregnancy weight. I lost over my first trimester. I haven't had like crazy like hunger or anything. So I've just been kind of eating not super healthy, eating pretty normally. And I had a lot of like aversions and just generally not feeling like eating during my first trimester. So I'm starting to catch up. And I am now over my pre-pregnancy weight, which feels good. Symptoms, the SPD just keeps slowly getting worse. I'm trying to do what I can to catch myself when I'm doing things that aggravate it, like putting pressure, you know, leaning on one leg rather than the other, crossing my legs when I sit down, which is a really bad habit of mine, or like trying to put on or take off pants while standing up. So I'm trying to be really good about, you know, mindful about my posture and stuff. And it's not fixing anything. My understanding is SPD is just kind of there and you can try to not let it get worse. So that's what I'm trying to do. I feel like I'm walking differently than I used to, that like I'm starting to feel like I'm a little bit, my center of gravity has shifted forward and I'm like leaning back as I walk. I'm definitely getting a lot of round ligament pain when I get up and down. So when I stand up, I'll sort of very slowly lean forward and then very slowly lift up. And that's how it's done. Because otherwise I get really bad knots on either side that take like a couple minutes to go away. And I just don't have time for that in my life. Most like 90% sure that I have felt some kicks, a couple that were like in the right spot and at the right time and the right sensation and not accompanied by gas to make me think that I actually have felt the baby move a couple times. But it's nothing really definitive yet. It's nothing predictable and it's nothing that I can like keep track of. So like I said, 17 weeks. They say that you might feel baby earlier on a subsequent pregnancy, and I was hoping that that would be the case, but it's been pretty much like it was last time, where I feel something, I go, is that baby? And then I feel like I have gas, and it's like, okay, well, no. And I'm always gassy in my second trimester, I guess, so, or at least it's maddening when you think it might be something else. Cravings, not really a lot. I ate a lot of pickles. We ran out of pickles and we had to have some hamburgers without pickles, and so I ordered some from Walmart grocery pickup. And as you know, right now, April 2020, like grocery orders are a mess right now, and so we end up with a whole bunch of substitutions every time we place an order. And so I ordered like the large jar of hamburger pickles, like you do, so that it'll last. They're not going to go bad, they're pickles. And it was out, like the store brand large jar was out, and so they substituted it with a name brand, but in order to keep the volume up, they substituted it with three jars. So we now have two extra jars in the cupboard. We're never gonna run out of pickles. So I've been eating a lot of pickles and they've been good, but I don't know if it's been a craving or if it's just that they're there and they're yummy. I have always liked pickles. No real aversions second trimester. Like I said, I had them a lot in my first trimester, but since then I've been eating a lot of junk food, but I think that's just because I'm working from home. And other than that, nothing really spectacular or out of the ordinary. So as for prep and like what I've been up to, it's COVID season, and so I haven't really been doing a lot of prep. Like, I'm not going out to stores and looking at things. I did make a registry on my last month, and I mentioned that in my last bump date. But we haven't bought anything off it yet. I think a lot of that stuff can just be put off, you know, until we're a little bit more sure about our financial situation. Like, we both still have our jobs, and we're pretty secure that we're going to continue to have our jobs, but it's just, like, everything seems so in flux. Plus, I think I talked about in my last video how we were planning to have a second crib, and I think that's still the case, but again, it also, like, it's so many months away now, still 5 months off, that who knows, my toddler might be ready for a toddler bed by then, plus another little amount of time, you know, the baby's still going to be in a bassinet in our room for the first 4 to 6 months, if we go by the same timeline as with our first. We moved her to her own room, I think, at 5 months after we'd done a little bit of bedtime training. The new baby might be in our room a little bit longer if she's still crying at night. So there might be a lot of time there where we actually are ready to move Agnes to a toddler bed before the baby takes the crib. So maybe I'll just do that instead of getting a second crib. Haven't decided yet. And I think we'll just kind of put a lot of these things off. You know me, I'm a planner. Look at me, I have my planner YouTube channel, so you knew that. And I would love the idea of the nursery already being ready to go for two, but I think it just makes a lot more sense to take things as they come. And really, there's nothing that we don't already still have from Agnes. I think if we were given a newborn today, we would be fine without having to buy anything. And so all of the things that I'd like to get, we'll just keep putting off until we feel like we need them a little bit more. We have a lot of wiggle room there. So things coming up in the next month, my anatomy scan is 2 weeks from yesterday, and in the midst of all of this going on, I'm a little bit nervous about that because the anatomy scan is in the building with the hospital. And like, I guess the COVID cases would come in through the ER, which is on the other side of the building, but still, you know, it's still, it makes me a little bit nervous. I'm pretty sure from what I understand when I talked to the OB at my last appointment, which was a phone appointment, it wasn't going to be, but it ended up just being a phone appointment, which I ended up being okay with. So I haven't seen the baby on an ultrasound since, I don't know, when was that? 9 weeks, something like that? 10, 11 weeks, maybe? About a month. I talked to the doctor and she said that she's pretty sure that right now they are not allowing partners to come in for the anatomy scan. So I'd have to go by myself, which is kind of sad. I think I'm going to ask the stenographer to put the gender in an envelope, so at least we can find out that together. And the last time, and I don't know if it was just because of the tech we had, or if it was policy, but for the large chunk of the scan, the screen was turned away from me so that I deliberately couldn't see the screen. I have no idea why, it just seems needlessly mean. Like, it wasn't even just, like, turned towards the sonographer, obviously, but it's like she deliberately turned it away from me and, like, angled it, like, between us so that I couldn't see the screen. My husband could see it, and so I was there holding his hand, watching his reactions, and that was at least something. But I'm like, if I'm gonna be there by myself, not even able to see anything for the large, you know, 45-minute chunk of the scan, it's just gonna be like, okay, that's nice. Anyway, I will update you on all of that in the next bump date for next month. But as for now, I'm just staying at home like everybody else. I'm like, I guess, the most immunocompromised in the household because of my pre-existing condition here. So my husband is the one doing the grocery runs, and he's working in the office more often than I am. I only run into my office to grab a couple papers like once or twice a week. I'm on week three, like I said, week three of working from home, and I haven't left the building since Friday, and I'm filming this on Tuesday. It's been raining, so once it stops raining, I want to go for a walk. Anyway, that's pretty much all I can think about right now is COVID stuff, and a lot of times between COVID and a toddler, I'm not really thinking about my pregnancy, and I guess it's a good thing that it's second trimester, and I don't have to, because there's nothing that's hindering me that much, unless I need to stand up or sit down. So that's pretty much where we are. If you found that interesting at all, hit that subscribe button, because I'm going to keep posting more videos about my pregnancy as it progresses, of course. And let's just stick this out, guys. We're in this together. I appreciate you sticking around with me, and look forward to see my, next video. I don't even remember. My planner video on Thursday. I'll see you in that one. Bye.